We're actually going. We're going to get the VFR fixed. Yay! New discs, new brakes, caliper clean, piston clean. Bloody Parcel Force. Should have delivered my brand new Nitron track shock with full compression and rebound and preload and reservoir, piggyback, hoses and all the rest. That should have been here yesterday. It's not here. So, pissed off because that was meant to get done along with this service. They told me that they're going to try and deliver it for 12:30, but I'm delivering the bike right now. So how's that going to work? Well, Doble of Honda are actually going to give me a courtesy bike. Although it's not really courtesy, I'm giving them so much damn money, they're kind of obligated to give me a bloody bike. And what I'm hoping is, I can use the courtesy bike, come home, very quickly pick up the shock, very quickly, and then try and make my way down there and still have enough time to get it fitted for by the end of business. Because of all the things that need to get done to this bike, the shock is the most important. The ride is really, really bumpy right now. Wondering what kind of courtesy bike they're gonna give me. Guy behind the desk said if he's feeling nice, he'll give me something nice. If not, he's gonna give me a moped. He fucking ain't. I'll take the brand new Firebird, please. The SP one, if you don't mind. Thanking you. So we're just making our way now through sunny South London, which is actually very grey. Yeah! Oh yeah, baby. Yeah, buddy. Too much traffic, man. Out the way. I don't know how people do it, man. You car drivers, kudos to you, man. Kudos to you for doing this every single day on a horrible, cloudy, dismal looking. To get up out of your bed and sit in this every single day for the rest of your life. Lord, couldn't pay me to do it. What have they done here? What am I doing? How not to filter volume one. There was a space on the left hand side. Get your head straight. Get your head there. Get your noggin down. Filter. Filtering is so much fun. Filtering is so much fun. Filtering is so much fun. Honda NC700S. What exactly have we got here? It's crazy. The fuel tank is under here on this bike. The fuel tank is actually there. I'll show you this. And under this bike, turn it that way. at that. Space for things. But it's not a moped. Look, it's got gears. Everything. It's proper. Parallel twin, which I've never ridden before. As a starter bike, doesn't look too bad to my eyes. Looks all right. Not sure what the brake horsepower is, but yeah. Rear tire looks like it could have seen better days, but it's nice jumping back on these not so serious bikes. The VFR is a serious bike. You ride it seriously. Something like this, third gear, take it nice and easy, you know what I mean? It's nice. You ain't got to worry about how you look or your image, because no one else cares. You're not going fast enough for anyone to look at you. It is a stylish bike though, I would say that. It's not, it's in no ways ugly at all. It's got, I don't know if you saw there, but on the rear, the tail light is not, you know how you normally have a tail light that's attached to the back of the tail? But this one isn't. It comes off on a kind of stalk. And where the license plate should be, that's where the rear brake light is. And then the tail looks really tidy. It's just nice, man. And I tell you what, the thing is with, I mean, look at this. You don't need no more poke than that. You're running around London streets. You do not need any more poke than that right there. Exhaust note, yeah, it's all right. It's all right, it's a parallel twin. It's never gonna set me on fire, is it? But you know the funny thing is about all bikes, man, I'm telling you, I'm not bored, you know, which is what you get with cars, you get bored. Nice Honda ST, nice. Something that you wanna go touring on, I think, that one there. It is a Honda, it is a ST, no, it's not an ST, is it? I'm not sure what this is in front of me. I thought it was a Honda Pan European or a ST. What is it? What is it? Curious. Now I want to pull up alongside, but dangerous. Exactly what you expect it to do. It's nice, man. I have to admit. It does what I want when I want to do it. It's got the grunt, man. I mean, it's a 700, so it will do what it's supposed to do, man. I mean, look at that. Here we go. And you know what else is really funny? It's windy today, man, and I don't know what this little screen is doing on the front, but I'm not feeling this wind at all. Oh man, do you know what? Sit up bikes, sit up and beg. I say sit up and have some fun, man. I'm telling you, I don't know, man. I don't know if I'm with the sports bikes again, man. These sit up bikes are so much fun. They are so much more fun. You get in that track focus position. Once you start leaning over like this, you're so serious. When you're sitting up like this, it's like you're on a BMX again. You feel like you're on a BMX and you're just taking the piss out of the whole road. It doesn't matter what the weather's throwing at you. I mean, if I was on my VFR now, making all kinds of noise. This little tiny 700 parallel twin, and you just think to yourself, seriously? Seriously, honest to God, for the amount of time I spend in London, and even if I wasn't in London, I'll be honest with you, these new bikes, man, I'm telling you, these new bikes, gone are the days, man, I'm telling you. I mean, it carves through the city just as well as anything, easier than my VFR to carve because of the power, chain driven, fun little bike. Ladies and gentlemen and ladies, if you're ever thinking about getting yourself a nice little upright bike, and do you know what else I've noticed about these upright bikes? Just being upright every bump, I mean, you heard that, right? You heard my voice go, every single bump in the road feels like it's neutered out.
I'm happy. I am feeling very happy, man. I think my next bike is a sit up and beg, man. I've said it.
So let's now move on this birthday day, which has started terribly. And I'm supposed to be picking up a package. Well, waiting for a package to arrive. My Nitron rear shock, fully adjustable. That should have been here from yesterday. But the day's already gone bollocks up. So, why don't we just come over here? Why don't we just do it? What's it like? I'm gonna take one out for a test.
Oh, utterly awesome. I've just come back from Portugal on it. I've been to Portugal and back on it. To be honest, it's £2.
I've got a VFR 12.
Yeah,
which
yeah,
is,
yeah,
I think, heavier than this.
Well, it's got, is it the automatic? Or the
it's the manual, but it's 267 kgs, I think, dry.
267?
Yeah.
I think that's about the same as
this. Okay, all right, yeah.
So you'll be all right. It's unbelievably fast.
Yeah, I've heard.
A Blackbird, I had a Blackbird before this.
Oh, yeah, the Honda, yeah.
And it's in a different, it's not in a different league. It's the next step up. I'm getting, not getting any younger.
Yeah.
And
none of us.
It's a bit much for me.
Yeah?
Yeah. I like going fast.
I said, I'm bringing in my VFR, please don't stick me on a moped. Just don't put me back on a moped. I can't go back to mopeds and all that nonsense, you know what I mean?
I bought a moped in 2007 and 2008. I've ridden motorbikes all my life. I fucking fell off it.
Yeah, but they make good mopeds, but you get no respect on the road.
No.
That's what it is. People look at you and they're like, oh, pizza boy.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
I'll just move over on him. I'll just turn, pull up along with this, and people just move to the left, I suppose. Yeah. Exactly.
Oh, when you're going, when the road's blocked, two lanes, and you go down the middle of them, they say,
like Jesus, like Moses.
I test rode the VFR 1200 automatic. I loved it. It was lovely.
Yeah.
Piece of piss to drive. Enjoy your ride on your.
It's really funny because I'm enjoying this.
Enormous power.
Yeah.
Oh, I'll tell you what I do like about it. It's got quite a high tick over. But that makes it easy to manoeuvre because you don't need to use the throttle for slow speed.
Oh, you're just clutching it in and moving it around. Yeah.
Nice talking to you.
Yes, you too, mate. That's the daddy, isn't it? That's the boy, isn't it? Ladies and gentlemen, what do we have here? That is my Nitron rear shock about to go on the bike. I was in the Kawasaki Ducati dealership looking at the new Multistrada, which I... They've just put brand new cameras there, man. Man, this used to be a good road, man. Just put them bloody new cameras there. You see that? Oh, it's another one of my favorite roads in Britain ruined. Little update. Are we recording? Little update on this this NC700S or X or whatever it's called. It's flipping marvelous. It's the only word I could use to describe it. I can see why the courier industry has started to use these now. They used to be on the CB6s and that. But the CB6 has started to get really nice. The CB600 and the Hornet, they're too nice now. They're really like becoming premium middleweight sort of like bikes. They're nice. This is just a workhorse. Revs to 6 and then jumps out. But it's all there. It's a 700. All the grunt is there, man. It's all... bars are a little bit shaky, though. Bloody hell. But then again, this is the courtesy bike. Who knows who's been riding it or doing what with it. But this just feels so easy, man. Sometimes the VFR can be hard work, you know. It's got the shaft drive, was a little bit clunkety. It's got that massive 1200cc engine, which is... Well, it's a 1200cc engine. It's a monster. And this is half the power, and you just for me, for some people this might be too much, you know, if you're brand new. But I think even a brand new guy who's just passed his test, he's gonna love this bike, man. So yeah, we was in the Kawasaki Ducati dealership. God knows what's happening. I'm either going through a midlife crisis early or something, but man, I initially went in there to try the ZZR 1400, because I thought, yeah man, that's the way to go. You're already on a 12, it's a big massive thing. You was never scared of the weight, which I never was, because before the VFR I was going to get the GSX 1250, the Suzuki GSX 1250 FA, which is the fully fared touring version, which is so old school. I mean, it's got a steel frame, not even an aluminium frame. It's got a steel frame. But I'm telling you guys, the new Ducati Multistrada, the DVT with the variable cam timing, the variable valve timing. Oh Lord, I haven't ridden it yet. Test ride is coming soon. But listen, let me tell you, please. Listen and let me tell you, please, ladies and gentlemen. It is a thing to behold in the flesh. Now, some of you, you're not gonna like the beak. You're not gonna like the way this thing looks. You're not even gonna like the way this thing goes down the road. I have been riding for so long inline fours for so long, and there is so much more to explore, you know what I mean. One day I'll probably even end up on one of these things here. Look, retro joints, cafe joints, although I doubt it, because the stuff, the adventure touring bike stuff, is all over. It's all over, man. They are in a different level now. Why would you want to be in a sports riding position anymore when you've got 160, 150 brake horsepower bikes coming out? That's it, mate. 68 point turn, that's it, you'll do it. Get it round, get it down. What is going on here? I don't like the poofling. Too many poofers in London, man. That's what clogs up all the roads. London is not a big city, man. My God, it's just poofers everywhere. Chronic poofers. Yeah man, why on earth would you do it? Why are you going to do it to yourself? You're not doing yourself any favours, right? So many of the guys, the older guys, will tell you about the reasons why they want to sit up now. The wrists have gone and this and that and the third is gone. And the wrists have gone. It's not from, well, it's not from too much of that shameful activity. Could be that, you know. Too much of this going on. Oh, my wrist hurt, mate. I can't ride sports bikes anymore. Why is that then? Oh, I've been doing too much calligraphy. Nah, it's not because of that. I think sometimes it's because you're just down. You're in this down position all day long. You know what I mean? 20, 30 years. It's got to do something. I don't know. You know, it probably doesn't, because I mean, I'll be honest with you, I've been on sports bikes, man. Yeah, that's it. You just come out, prick. I've been on sports bikes my whole life. I'm not an old elderly guy, so probably doesn't affect my wrist that much. I'm going to try out I went in there to try out the ZZR. Came away now. Comes to it that now I want the Z1000 SX. The tour, which he said to me, that's the touring version. That's what I love about some of these guys, man, in the bike industry. They ride as themselves. They're enthusiasts. They're not like car dealership guys. Some of the guys in the car dealerships, they're on the bus. Do you know what I mean? The guys who sell the bikes, man, a lot of them, you talk to them, you get chatting to them. It could all just be sales bullshit that they've been taught to say, but I don't think so, man. You know, you speak to a lot of these sales guys, they're riders, man. They've been on bikes. Their bikes are parked up outside. Their 10-year-old GSF is outside. You know what I mean? Rather than him trying to fleece more money out of me by selling me the ZZR, full Olin spec, Olin's front and rear Akrapovics, 14 grand, instead of him trying to sell me that, he's trying to sell me the cheaper bike, because he said that's more suited to what I think you want. And I think what I want, ladies and gentlemen, is a sit up and beg. When you get on them VF, when you get on them sports bikes, it puts you in a mind frame. It's not that I speed everywhere, but I know that I've got it and I use it, you know? I know that I've got it and so I use it. And because, I mean, I'm doing 20, 30 miles an hour on this bike, this sit up and beg bike, right? And I can feel it. I can feel all 20, 30 miles raw, naked. 20, 30 miles an hour on my bike, my VFR, it feels like I'm crawling around. Little motorcycle tip there for you. Even when filtering in traffic, always look clean over to your left-hand side. You'll save yourself a lot of accident and injuries. No matter whether you're filtering or not, it's not about just looking here and there. Look clean over there, especially when you know there's side roads. It's London, man. It's London. This is how it rolls. And you have to think. A lot of people get into accidents on bikes, and it's because they're not thinking about the driver. And you have to. You ride a motorcycle, you need to be thinking about what's this guy in this Mercedes doing? What's he doing? Is he turning? Does he know what he's doing? Are you looking through the rear view mirror? I spend a lot of my time looking through the rear view mirror of people's cars, just judging, assessing their movements, you know, looking at what they're doing. Do they know where they're going? Is he someone who's unsure? Is he about to pull an emergency stop? You could see sometimes, you see the shoulder tense up, you see them looking left and right, and you know, it just gives you that millisecond look around you guys on the bikes, not being patronizing. Let's all be a bit careful out there. Idea. Oh, there's some wind floating around today. It's windy in Croydon, baby. Is this package even still on the back? Better check. Yeah, it's still there. It's still there. You know what? I'm having such a good time. I'm taking a long way around. I know these guys are looking for this shock. I could go down there and head down into the Brighton Road. I'm going this way. Let's see what she does. Catch the Corsa, baby! Catch the Focus, baby! Woo! Good bike. Lightweight, good bike. Yeah, buddy. Yeah, buddy. Good bike. Honda, you're doing it well, man. You're doing it well. When it comes to the budget bikes, Honda, you're doing it well. Little storage under here. Oh, it's good. It's good shit. 700cc is good. It's good. I love this one. This one I give to myself. I bought another one to give to my wife. I also give to myself. I love this one. Good bike, good city bike, man. This is one of them. Yeah, got to pop down the road, grab this, and this is one of those. I've got a day off work. I've got lots of running around to do in London. I've got to pick this up. I've got to pick that up. Get two straps on the back. Throw whatever else in there. Your wallet, your phone, and go. It's one of them. Don't matter if I got to touch a bit of dual carriageway. Don't matter if I got to touch a little bit of motorway. Get in it, jump on it, go. And then, just for good measure, what has Kawasaki done? They've parked their dealership smack right bang next to the Ducati dealership, baby. The dreaded Ducati. I say dreaded Ducati because let's do stereotypes. Ducatis of old, what are they? Beautiful pieces of exotica, right? That's what they are. For the average Joe, when you look at the price point, let's say for example you're in the market for a sports bike, okay? You want something fast and nimble and slipping through and could take it to the track. Ducati have got a version of something like that. Back in the day it was called the 998. Suzuki have got a version of something like that. They call it the GSX. You could probably get two GSXs for the price of a 998 back in the day, and now, especially now, you can get three GSXRs, all different Ks. Good brakes. What? Now look at the traffic, man. Still want a car, do ya? Still want a car? and we are at the front. Gotta take it easy out there, man. You have gotta take it easy, baby. Oh man, we jumped on the multi-strada for 2 seconds. I'm going back there in a minute. And I have a word with Kevin. I'm gonna say, Kevin, say it nice. Ladies and gentlemen, like I always say, you can't forever listen to these reviewers. They have their own agendas. They have their reasons for loving and liking who they love and like. Wanna know what these bikes are all about? Get on these beasts and test them for yourself. It's bad when you're your own courier service, isn't it? It's bad when you're your own courier service.
Yeah.
Delivering, collecting your own shock for your own bike that you're servicing. It's bad, isn't it? Might be a pink fluffy teddy bear.
You could be lucky.
Yeah.